What a privilege and an honor to be here today and to be in the service of God. The one thing that I realized when I was hospitalized was, by God's grace, we can all meet again. And these special parents that we have this morning with this precious, precious gift from God. Myself and Pastor Michael saw Gugu grow up as a little girl herself. And Skylar is so privileged that she has God-fearing parents and grandparents. That is a great, great blessing. And today, in speaking about Gugu and Skylar, I would like to call to the front the mother, the father, and this precious little bundle. Okay, so this morning we want to welcome Lawrence and Gugu Mala. Okay? And of course, Colin. Also, a very warm welcome to the family and friends and the grandparents this morning. And this morning, Gugu, I would like to say to you, you know, when a child is born, it's a new life, and we speak about a new beginning. God is the beginner, and he will finish what he started. Okay? And life is a journey, and God decided that the two of you will be on this journey, taking this little one through life. But there's one promise though that God made. When Jesus ascended to heaven, he said, I'm leaving behind for you the Holy Spirit, the one that will comfort you, that will help you, that will guide you, that will lead you. And you know, every time that you get a new product or something new, there's usually a manual to give you the instructions of how to use it. Now your manual for the rest of this journey will be the Word of God. Whenever you need wisdom, get it from him. Because he's the master above all masters. All the wisdom belongs to him, okay? So I have some questions that I need to ask you guys this morning, okay? So, it's a commitment by the parents and a public confession. So are you as parents willing to accept responsibility, and can you declare our will to the following? Is it your desire to publicly, in the presence of the witnesses here present, to dedicate and set apart Sky to the Lord by giving God legal right that she would be his special possession and to be used for his honor and glory? Do you covenant with God to teach your child the Holy Scriptures and seek to lead Sky to unconditional love and the saving faith of the Lord Jesus Christ? Do you covenant with God to set before Sky a godly example of prayer, meditation of the Word, God-ordained relationships in the body of Christ, and a lifestyle pleasing to God? Okay, I want to share with you as Isaiah 49 verse 1 to 2. And we see clearly that this is supporting. So when I pray over Skylar, this is something I want to do. I would like to anoint her. In the Old Testament we see that they anointed people that they set apart for the Lord. Okay. So when we anoint, God will appoint. Okay, and in Isaiah we see that long before she was ever born, God has called her by her name. She's here today for a reason and a purpose. And our prayer would be that God will help her to fulfill her purpose and live a life to the fullest. But apart from that, her name is also written in the palm of his hand. And God will be the protector and the provider for this child for the rest of her life. And I proclaim over her life and yours as well Jeremiah 29, verse 11. And it's not to be taken lightly, because God says, I know the plans that I have for you. Okay? It's plans of peace and not of evil. To give you a future and a hope. Okay? Prosperity will be yours. Protection will be yours. Provision will be yours for the rest of your lives. And if I can give you one good piece of good advice for the rest of your life, stay in unity. When you are united in Christ Jesus, that makes it so much stronger to work together as a team. And God is part of this covenant today, and He will be for the rest of your lives. Can we call the grandparents to the front as well? Can we ask the grandparents to come to the front as well, please? In the precious name of your Son Jesus, we bow before you today. Lord, as we are here today gathered together as witnesses of what the covenant of God says about this little precious Skylar, Father, thank you that the love of God will be with her, the unconditional love, and that she will be a joy to everyone. Father, thank you that people will experience peace whenever she enters into a place. Lord, thank you, for the joy of the Lord will be her strength forever, and the inner peace of God shall follow her. Prosperity, protection, and provision shall be hers for the rest of her life. Father, thank you that we can call up the Spirit now to be in contact with the Most High Living God. Lord, we cut her loose from any and every bloodline curse in the almighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we bless her. In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, spirit, soul, and body into wholeness. Thank you, Father God, that you have given this precious life to be a joy, a life, and a light to this world. Lord, and if we just think that you have said to Sarah, nations will come forth from your womb. In Jesus' name, we will claim it over. Father, she shall be a leader. She shall lead in the wisdom and the understanding of Christ. And Lord, as I'm anointed today, I know that you will appoint. And thank you, Almighty God, that the blessing of God is hers forever. In Jesus' name, amen. I'm going to ask Pastor Michael to pray over the prayers.
Right, let us stretch out our hands and let's pray for the parents and the grandparents. Oh, Heavenly Father, what a privilege today to come and to pray for these special people, Father God, your anointed. And today, Heavenly Father, I want to bring Sky's father and mother, Lawrence, who led you before you. And as we lay our hands on them, Father God, we ask that you will anoint them, that you will bless them, as well as the grandparents, Stephen, Dundee, and that you will give them the wisdom and the understanding in order to raise Sky to your will and your way. Thank you that you will protect them, that you will be with them. Heavenly Father, we don't only dedicate Sky to you today, but also dedicate the parents and the grandparents, Heavenly Father, because they are a family. And I ask Heavenly Father that you will equip Lawrence, Stephen, as men, as fathers, as husbands, as grandparent, grandpa, in her life and in the lives of their families, and that you will equip Gugu, that you will equip one day when she's Big Sky, as well as grandma, in order to be what you called them to be, Father God, and that you will anoint them and help them as a family. Thank you so much that what's happening here is your perfect will. We love you. Thank you that you first loved us. Thank you, Father God. And therefore, Tandi, Lawrence, Gugu, Stephen, we anoint you, we bless you for the role that you have to play in the life of this little one. And all of us sitting here as a congregation, as a family, will also be responsible to bring our children up the way that God calls us and tells us in truth. In Jesus' name, amen. We just want to hand the certificate to you as well. Pastor Green, will you do that, please? There you go. There's your certificate. Right, let's give them a hand. Thank you so much. That was so special. You know, we could just feel the anointing in front, and we know that, you know, this is so special to God.